Next, we have Patrick. People, work continues on the new Mississippi River Bridge, but in East St. Louis, they've unearthed some interesting artifacts. And today's Patrick's People, Patrick Clark, shows you some of the items they found, and where they're from might surprise you.
Patrick Durst isn't digging for gold, but he found the tool that could have done so a few thousand years ago.
This would be fastened or lashed onto a handle or a stick and used for agriculture.
It's been a virtual gold mine at the old stockyards in East St. Louis. For the past 4 years, they've been uncovering artifacts as work progresses on the new Mississippi River Bridge.
It's sort of an unparalleled opportunity to investigate a very large portion of a major mound center and major residential complex in the Midwest.
Durst and a team of 80 archaeologists have determined that from 900 AD to 1200 AD, as many as 3,500 people lived where the stockyard stood. And like nearby Cahokia Mounds, this site might have had more.
At one time, historically, there were anywhere from 40 to 50 mounds documented associated in this area with this site. And throughout history, starting as early as the Civil War period, those gradually became leveled due to some of the industry and railroad expansion in the East St. Louis area.
They've unearthed evidence that a sprawling metropolis stretched for 8 miles on both sides of the river.
And you can see this in decorative incising that was done during its manufacturing, and you can even see the pigmenting and staining that was placed on this intentionally to decorate it.
His teams found arrowheads, trowels, even shark teeth and conch shells.
From Wisconsin, Michigan, Northern Illinois, shells from the Gulf of Mexico, things like that, that are obviously being traded to this area.
But the native Mississippians made time for fun. This chunky stone, their choice for gameplay.
So that's our ancient St. Louis Cardinals. This
they didn't have a baseball team, so this is the best thing that we can come up with.
Through progress, we're rediscovering the past and priceless items worth more than their weight in gold. Patrick Clark, News 11.